The idea of an alliance is a simple concept. When someone is in trouble, you help. When you're in trouble, someone helps you. This basic idea is the basis for the North Atlantic Treaty Organization, shortened to NATO. NATO is an agreement made up of countries such as the US, UK, and Australia. The agreement states that if one or more countries are in danger or conflict, then the rest of the countries have to provide support and defense. Although it was originally made to tackle the Cold War and the spread of communism, today it is used mostly for strengthening the global economy and international security. So the question is, why is NATO in trouble, and why should I care? When I used to live in Japan, I had no real thoughts about politics since it didn't really affect me. That was until 2016 when Donald J. Trump was elected president of the United States. Japanese television seemed to focus a lot more on Chinese politics and the alliance with the Republic of China. Behind the curtain, the alliance with America was weakening. Every week there would be protesters outside of military bases telling Americans to leave. That was a small sign of something big brewing in other countries. The origin of NATO's worst issue seemed to stem from an article in the NATO agreement. Countries are mandated to pay 2% of their GDP, gross domestic product. Much of the countries in NATO do not meet the yearly pledge. It was addressed for decades by a push from our past presidents. With Donald Trump, NATO has been more under pressure to meet their required payments. Because of the lack of funding, the US has pulled out of several international allied agreements. China and Russia, who are not in NATO, have been growing as strong contenders for the next global superpower. China, being the second most powerful economy, is a concern for the US, as NATO allies such as Japan and Korea have deepened their relationship with the country as a backdoor to America's insignificant support. Comparably, countries in Europe are creating agreements with Russia. This is causing a lack of necessity for America's support, which means the US could lose global dominance. If that happens, supporting armies would pull out of American wars. With fewer armies, the wars in countries like Afghanistan would be harder to fight. War between the US, China, and Russia, as well as terrorism, could also become a higher possibility. Luckily, several outspoken individuals and advisors are urging those in power to think about the decisions they're making. Going out and protesting for re-establishment in the Paris Agreement, the World Trade Organization, and most importantly NATO, is the best way to counteract our weakened partnerships.